This is day three of going through the papers. Today I am going through more folders. So I went through folders yesterday and I have two full bags of trash and paper. The thing is, like, I know, because I know it's not eco-friendly. It bothers me, but I also know that people say too many papers can be a fire hazard. Now, I don't know if that's true or not. People can get upset or whatever. I think it just, I don't know. I feel bad that I'm doing it. But at the same time, for people who hoard papers, I think there's a line between when it's not okay. And it's, if I was stubborn still, as I usually am, I think I blame it on family genetics. I was stubborn like I was as a child, it would be 10 times worse. As a child, people couldn't touch my stuff. And if you did, I knew you touched it. I knew. Because everything had a spot. And even the tiny things, I knew if they were moved. If you took something from my room, I'd also know. So, you know, you can imagine when my parents would go to my room and they would start cleaning, it would be a tantrum. As like a young child, a tantrum. As I got older, it became yelling. And then as I got to middle school, also yelling. So, like, middle school was just a time where kids just want to be accepted, just want to have fun. And I think middle schoolers are very harsh. They are quick to judge. They will tear teachers down limb through limb verbally. That's just what they do. I don't know if you guys know it, but around East Coast, kids find learning to be a joke. It's actually pretty sad. I don't know if it's all my classes, but all my classes, most kids saw life and education as a joke. And I feel like a lot of my friends could probably, like, the friends I had in the past could probably understand that. Because, like, kids just, like, didn't take class seriously. I think I took it too seriously. But I really just wanted my dream so badly. I was, like, that determined. Like, when you're that career-driven that you just throw social life out the window slightly. But I also really wanted a social life. But I think in some ways I'm glad I didn't follow into most of the things that a lot of people did. I think I'm glad that I waited to more see the world as I got older, because I actually, I feel like I have a healthier life than if I was to do the reverse. Because my life got very unhealthy in college, and it took me a while to, like, realize that, and then want to change my life. Where many kids realize that, I think, in high school, where I didn't really have that. So, like I said, it's just, like, middle school is just a very strange time. You know, it's just kind of, it's kind of strange. I wish there was some, there are some changes. Like, I definitely wish I could have made some changes. I think that would have been helpful. But as a child, so flash to getting home from school. And, you know, I'd have my sweet snack because I was an extreme sugar tooth back then. And I was very experimental with sweets. And I actually made some really great ideas that I'm very happy about. But I can't go back to that lifestyle. This is really bad. If my parents were to clean my room, it would just be yelling. And I would just a lot of yelling.
Hello, editor, me. This is June 14th. Currently, I have a cold I caught from one of my relatives. If anyone's watched this, I'm summing up, like, a few sections of me talking and going on and on and on to get to a point. What I'm summing up is stress management. I didn't learn anything about that until high school. Middle school, it was kind of confusing. I think there was just a lot of students in the study skills that I was in, and teachers didn't get to all of us. I think that might have happened. I don't remember learning stress management techniques at all. I do remember having a counselor who was kind of harsh with me, and I don't remember her healing any of my problems, actually. I know her name. I know, like, I just feel like towards me, like, when I was put in a group, like, the guidance counselor, I was in a group of people. And I just remember the way she would talk to me because I didn't understand certain social situations and emotional things. I didn't get that. It took me time to understand that and to get there. But, I didn't get to learn much. I don't remember much helpful anything coming out of middle school on a stress management level. It was more of, like, what I learned was more academic and art-based. And that's what went into high school. Middle school was kind of, like, shitty on, like, how people are. But with my friends, it was, like, that was the better times when things were at peace. People were great. They were, like, my friends were just great. They were kind. That's when life was good. Flash to high school is very different. People changed, and I don't feel like they changed for the better, because I just remember things just not going well and people becoming meaner. And I don't understand that or where that came from, but I also don't live with people. So I only live with my household. So it's like I didn't live with my friends, so I didn't see whatever was bothering them or whatever was going on. I wasn't able to see that. But I just remember that you had really nice people, and then you go into like high school and like things just go sour. They just go not good, and they just become meaner. And it's very strange. They become rude and they say things that they shouldn't say, or they say things that are really hurtful or really toxic to your mental health or emotional health. So it's like a matter of all of that. So middle school was like the good times, you know? But like on a level of how I was in middle school, I accumulated a lot. I was the kind of person that I had to buy something out of every store that I went into. Every store I went into, I had to buy something. And I don't know where that came from. I don't know why it did, but it did. And I accumulated a lot. As a grown adult now, I do have a lot of regrets on that level, because I accumulate too much and it's hard to get rid of stuff. Or I get too sentimental. So that's a problem here. Is I accumulated way too much in the span of my lifetime. It happened. Okay, you have a person with ADD and they don't like change. Most kids do not like change. That's another thing. So that happens. You know, I didn't like change then. I'm fine with it now. But like, I didn't like change then as a kid. And it doesn't mean anything about me as an adult now. It doesn't mean anything. Because that's like two different lifestyles. Like, there are two different lifetimes. But yeah, I didn't like change. And I dealt with it by yelling at people. Because because my family, we're all Italian. We all yell at each other. That's just what we did. That's how we talk. That's what we do. It's not bad. So it's like, that's just... But I will tell you, if a stranger yelled at me, that bothers the hell out of me. Because, like, it's different if it's my parents or my family. It's like, I get that. But if a stranger were to yell at me, like, holy shit. Like, that's a scary feeling. Because strangers are, that's unpredictable. And I don't know what goes on behind their mind. But at least I have my own family figured out. But, like, that's different. Like, strangers is different.
To what I was saying, middle school. So, to any of the people from high school... If you're watching this, hi, hello. You might have been extremely toxic to my well-being. Either you knew it or you didn't know it, or you just, I don't know, you're bored out of your marbles and you like to pick on the things that you thought were weak. You probably thought I was a weakling. Well, I was following the school rules. If I knocked you out on the playground, I'd probably get in trouble. But I played by the rules. That's what kids do. If you want to get farther in life, you play by the rules. But I probably was imagining knocking you out in my mind. Like, I probably imagined, even if I was quiet or giving you the evil eye, you know something was going on in my head. You know something was happening. Because I was imagining a different world, a completely different world, where I could break the rules and I could do things. And none of that would have happened in the first place. I learned differently, and I mature slowly. So let's pick on her, because, hi, as an adult, hi, really, it's just pathetic. I could go on and on about my hatred for bullies and, like, how upset it makes me. And now, I guess I stick up for kids because I feel bad that they're going through this. We had people come into our school to talk about bullying. You know, you have to be nice. That's what they say. You have to be nice. Oh, the Catholic, we have to see the good in everybody. That's what we do. And I tried for this for most of the part, but I really, some people were just pain in the ass shitheads. They were completely terrible. And now they're like nurses and teachers and parents and like working with children with disabilities. And I'm just like, what on earth makes you think you should work with kids with disabilities concerned for those children that you are now working with? And I don't feel like you deserve to be able to be around those blessings, because children are complete blessings. I think you probably pick the easy route, because most people think that teaching is easy when it's really not. But like, as an adult, I've heard of so many teachers that just shouldn't be teaching, and I bet they were bullies growing up, you know? I also don't know why these never-ending cycles happen. It's something else. And I think the teachers just don't do anything. I don't know if they enjoy it or what. Are they sadists? Are teachers sadists because they don't try to protect the kids from getting bullied? You know, they don't do anything. Private schools are too wild, and it's actually extremely concerning. So a lot to look up to, and I'm at a point, because I've been getting rid of stuff so much, clothing and stuff, I actually like seeing space on my floor. I really do. knowing that my under my bed is clear and like my floor is clear, that you might have like a really nice feeling. And I actually am the kind of person that I cannot stand clothing on the floor. That was just me growing up. I think it's because I'm allergic to dust, and so it's like I just can't. There's kind of like different things. You know, it's like I just know that I don't like having too much stuff. That's the part I'm at right now. I don't like having too much stuff. I also realized a big time when I went to Ireland, I had to lug my suitcase and stuff around with me. I had like 4 bags. Like, what in God's name was wrong with me? I got so excited just to travel. I packed outfits for like every occasion, and I really like organized what I was gonna wear because it really meant a lot to me. Like, clothing means a lot to me. So it's like, fashion's a big deal. You go to Ireland. I didn't realize I should have prepared better for the weather. But it wasn't even the weather. It was carrying all my stuff around with me. I was getting tired. I would fall asleep on the bus. I was so tired. I can't do that. And if I think about it, after watching all the van life videos and tiny house videos, you're gonna move from state to state or whatever. You're gonna lug all your crap with you. It's like, that's heavy. That's too much. And through watching so many of the videos of like minimalism and RV life and van life and tiny houses, I don't need as much. If I'm gonna ever want to move place to place, that's not gonna happen. I can't be lugging my crap around with me. And I understand with like my furniture, I can leave my furniture behind. I am blessed with the most beautiful furniture I think that I've seen in a very long time. And I need to treat it better. I do know that. Some things are just really important furniture wise. But yeah, it's just crazy. So I learned a lot on my Ireland trip, not just from the history, not just from the land, and not just from the culture, everything around that. But just as a person, I was just realizing how much crap it is that I'm carrying, and I don't like it. Yeah, so it's crazy. So, I can't go backwards. That's not healthy. I need to go only forwards. So forwards, as in, like, I have a lot of books on the side of me I need to go through. A lot of them are magazines, and most of my books that are not, like, art books are actually comic books. I have a lot of comic books. I don't know what to do with them all. You probably won't see any of these videos for a while. I don't feel comfortable posting right now. I will post it when the time is right. It's probably going to be deeper into summer. With the papers, yeah, I'm just going through stuff. So, yeah, I'm going to film going through some more stuff. And I'm to have some changes in my room this week. I changed some artwork around because I wanted to change it up a little bit. And then there's... So, like, there's some of the surfaces in my room. Currently, one of my surfaces is my dresser, which is a shrine for my grandparents. And I don't know how they feel about it, but, like, hopefully they like that I have a shrine. Hopefully it's going well. I mean, in some of my, like, for some of my relatives that are very Catholic and old, they're kind of old country Catholic Italian, we have, like, people have shrines. My house doesn't have any shrines, but I actually really love traditions, and I love going back to traditions. So I wanted to have a shrine for my grandparents because it makes sense. And I'm not that close to the cemetery where I can just see them. So in a way, I like seeing their photos and stuff around them that either was theirs or reminded me of them. So that, yeah, it's kind of like what it is. I have my mantle of little things, but I'm going to change it to antique cameras and then some photos. And my bureau, my TV stand, and then my perfume section. So my TV stand needs to, like, be a little lessened of what it is. It looks like a little fairy house, but also it's there's a tiny little village set from, I think, Paris that got a yard sale. And no, it was a church fair, yeah. And then my bureau, and I need to work on my bureau, but yeah. So it's kind of like, there's like some stuff still. And my closet capsule wardrobe. I want to work on that too, but yeah, it's kind of where I'm at. You know, I think self-growth in this quarantine time is very important. And if you have time to figure out more about yourself, and more about the life you want and the life you want to be surrounded by, this is the time, you know, time for self-growth. It's not really, I mean, it's understanding to take it day by day, like I am, but it's not good to get bogged down by depression. I know it's very tough. I get depressed, and when I do, it's tough to pull myself out sometimes. My mom tries her best to help cheer me up, and through that, I try to cheer up, and I try to, see different pictures, but... Yeah, it's like an up and down thing you can't really control, so I do understand that. But I do think quarantine is a good time for self-growth. And there's some things I'm going to try doing before I turn 25. They say when you turn 26, that is the time when you are wise, when you've completed maturing. So it's kind of interesting. To some degrees, I feel like I've already matured, but in some ways, I'm also always going to be improving. I'm never complete. Always remember that. We are never 100% done growing. We are always improving. So think of it like that, okay?